Hello everybody, Sean here, and we are taking a look at the Lakshmi fight. This is the story version found at level 67, although the maximum level inside the instance is 68. When the fight begins, there will be two thralls that you need to kill first, the dreaming enemies that you see here. And there's nothing too noteworthy about them other than the fact that they can be healed by Lakshmi, so if their health suddenly goes up, you didn't do anything wrong, that's just part of the fight. Focus your DPS one at a time, that way you could just burn through them, and hopefully it will only take you a few seconds to do so. You'll also notice that you have a 1 out of 1 charge of a special thing that's appearing right in the middle of your screen. This is called Vril, will be very important later on. Make sure to absolutely not click that unless it's a very, very important skill going off, and we will cover which skills those are. Once the two thralls are dead, you can start tanking Lakshmi and dealing damage to her. As the main tank, pretty simple. Just grab enmity and go from there. There is one tank buster we will discuss a little later, but otherwise, it's a pretty straightforward fight for the tank. For the DPS and healers, you can see there's two main AoEs that they're going to have to deal with. The first is the one you just saw where two people will get targets placed upon them. There can be more than two, keep this in mind, but generally speaking, two people will have targets placed upon them, and then these crisscrosses will appear. What those two people need to do is get to the far outsides of the arena and then position themselves in such a way so that they don't hit each other, and they leave ample room so that the rest of the party can go somewhere and not be hit. Typically, what you want to do is basically have those two people, or three people, however many it is, basically form a large box. So you want one person in the far northeast corner, while the other person goes to the far southwest corner. That way a large safe area appears in the middle of the arena for everyone to go to. Now once you've done enough damage, you will trigger her second phase. So as soon as you see her go to this area of the arena, and then she will put a shield up and then soon disappear, use your Vril. The Vril lasts for a minute, so you can safely use it well in advance. Don't worry about it running out. As soon as you see this event happening, immediately use your Vril. This is her ultimate attack, and she will one-shot you if you do not have your Vril active. Once the ability is over, you can pick up a new Vril, and that's very, very important. Throughout this fight, you're going to have to use your Vril, first for this attack, and then later on for one called Divine Denial. Every time you use a Vril, make sure to pick up a new one, and she will always lay down more orbs so that you can get new Vril. So every time you're at 0 of 1 and you see an orb on the ground, pick it up immediately, because the orbs only last about 10 seconds, so there is a chance that you miss it and then are going to die when she uses Divine Denial. So right here is an example of Divine Denial going off, popping the Vril, and I will take very little damage. You'll notice in the top left, a couple people don't pop it in time, a couple people die. It is a very damaging skill. Divine Denial goes off every time she goes to the middle of the arena, so you need to use a Vril ASAP. It's also noteworthy that Divine Denial has a minor pushback. You can fall off this arena, so if you are right on the edge when Denial goes off, you're probably going to get knocked off and die regardless of how much Vril you have. Now, aside from Denial, she does have more AoEs that we need to talk about. We spoke of the Align AoE a little earlier, but there is also Hands of Beauty, which is the other major AoE she uses, which you see on the ground currently. Two party members will be marked with a circular AoE around them. They need to go to the farthest points away from the party and drop that on the ground. The fire will then hit the ground and stay there, and under certain conditions will expand. However, if the party has moved the fire far enough away, even if it expands all the way, you'll still be safe. So you don't usually have to worry about the expansion part of the AoE. Just have those party members get as far away from Lakshmi as possible, drop the AoE, and then you can pretty much forget it, and you should be A-okay. That is, again, the Hands of Graces, and there's also the other hands attack where, again, she uses the lines instead of the circles. This is another example of Divine Denial. Again, make sure you use your Vril. You'll also notice that throughout the fight, Lakshmi uses a ability that basically turns her into an evil-looking Super Saiyan. She'll have a black aura around her. During this time, she'll just use other abilities. It's nothing really noteworthy. It's most important for the healers that when they see Lakshmi in this phase, expect to need more healing than usual, because she will be doing more party-wide damage and particularly more tank damage. So During this time, it's good to pop any additional healing potencies you might have. So aside from Divine Denial, aside from the two hand attacks that create line or circular based AoEs, what else is there? Because there's always more in these primal fights. Well, there's also the Pull of Light and the Pall of Light. The Pall of Light is a AoE that will hit the rest of the party minus the main tank. It has a large circular stacking AoE, so it's very clear. Anytime Pall of Light is used, a person will have a stacking AoE indicator on them. All you have to do is stack up and mitigate the damage, and you can see that right there, the Pall of Light, we stack up. Excellent timing, everyone lives, carry on with the fight. The Pull of Light is a tank buster. It will only hit the main tank. It does a lot of damage. If you're in max gear and you don't use any buffs, expect the Pull of Light to do 20, possibly 30,000 damage. It is extremely strong. So anytime you see the Pull of Light being used and you are the main tank, pop the strongest cooldown you have. If you don't have the strongest cooldown, in a Dark Knight's case, it's a 30% buff. If you don't have your strongest, pop your next. Pop something, because it's going to be a lot of damage. If you are not at full health, be prepared to either die or use one of your abilities to make you invincible for a short time, because it is extremely strong. Definitely one of the most troublesome tank busters in Stormblood right now. So, just as a recap, we have the Pull of Light, which is a tank buster. Make sure you use a cooldown on that. There is the Pall of Light, which is a stacking AoE. Make sure you stack up to mitigate damage. She has her two hand attacks. One will form a line AoE, which you need to spread out and make sure you don't get knocked off the arena and hit. The other hand attack will create a circular AoE that drops a flaming circle on the ground. You need to drop that as far away from Lakshmi as possible, and then just stand very, very far from the flames. And then, of course, she has her Super Saiyan mode, where she basically does more damage and specifically more party-wide unavoidable damage. Really is just a healer check at that point. There's not much the party can do. And lastly, there is the Divine Denial and Vril mechanic. So make sure to always have 1 out of 1 Vril, and anytime she uses Denial, that you pop your Vril. With all that said, and a little sprinkle of luck, you will get through the Lakshmi fight and be able to carry on through the story. I hope this video helps. I thank you for watching, and we'll see everyone next time.